morning. Welcome to the house of the Lord. I would like to introduce the service today by giving thanks. Giving thanks to the Lord, who is always present with us and who is always here for us. Whether we have the Lord or not, we have to face ups and downs, trials, circumstances, and anything that this world can offer. But we, as His children, as His sons and daughters, we have a blessed hope, we have a blessed assurance that He is with us, that He will hear us and hear our cries and heal our land. I mean, can you imagine going through anything in life and not knowing that we can call upon His name, upon the name of Jesus? And He always gives us rest and He always gives us peace. So let's thank Him this morning for being there for us and for loving us and for dying on the cross for our salvation. Because there's no other love greater than this. We thank You, Lord. We magnify Your name. We exalt Your name, Lord. And we thank You for having You as our unfailing rock, Lord. We thank You, Jesus, for Your everlasting presence in our lives. We thank You, Lord, for our brethren, Lord, because we are all a family. We are never alone, Lord, because we have You and we have our brothers and sisters, Lord. And we know that, Lord, that You are honored when we pray for each other, when we fast for each other's needs, Lord, and when we are there for each other. And we thank You, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Give Him praise and glory, because we were made for that purpose. Thank you. Of our lives. Because because that is the way people approach him. We cannot approach him if we have resentment in our hearts, if we have grudges against others, because he loved each and every one of us and died for each and every one of us. Our name was written in his heart. Hallelujah. And that is how much we must be enthusiastic in our hearts to keep thinking about him and to filter all our decisions through his will. Hallelujah. My life is in you.
Thank you.
Your spirit to be shining to us. Hallelujah.